I'm getting tired of your chatter. Hand over 100 caps or we start using you for target practice.
Oh, you just gave me all the justification I needed. In that case, maybe I'll do the town a favor and take you down.
So be it. Perhaps your corpse will be better at coughing up the caps.
Over here!
Well done, gentlemen. We showed them who was boss. The law. That's who's boss. Alright, yeah, okay, it was a bit of a cheesy line. Give me a break. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to Let's Play Fallout New Vegas, where we have just finished teaching Layla here and her buddies how this nebulous concept called the law works. And we've also been teaching them why it's a very bad idea to start insulting and demanding 100 caps from a one-eyed bounty hunter, a super mutant, and a man with a Remington shotgun and a very sharply dressed suit. Our work here is done, gentlemen. And we should probably just be moving on. Steve clearly isn't here. In fact, the whole damn casino is deserted. He's probably moved into the Bison Steve itself now, I suppose. Still, that was an interesting little encounter. And look, it's not like I didn't take any pleasure out of it, honest. I'm not a weirdo like you. Okay, maybe I took a little pleasure out of it, but it's because they tried to shake me down 100 caps first. I just sort of, you know, I just wanted to shoot her in a smug face. Nah, whatever. I refuse to admit he's got a point. I refuse. We can rebuild him. Show location. Yes, he is in fact inside the Bison Steve. Somewhere. Holy crap. The layout of the whole damn building has changed.
Prim has a new sheriff.
They've been knocking down walls and stuff, haven't they? I'm impressed, Steve. I'm impressed.
Well, look who's back and right on time. We just got this place all cleaned up. I bet you got some good news on the lights.
Yes, I have the lighting shipment receipt you asked for.
Okay, great. According to this, the lights should ship in a day. It won't take long to install them once they're here. Hey, what do you think about the place? Once we got it all cleaned up, it looks a lot better than I thought it would. I know it's dark in here, but we'll get those lights installed in no time, and it'll look real nice.
I think you did a little more than just clean up, but yeah, okay, will do. You mentioned furniture earlier.
Yep, sure did. We already rounded up most of the stuff we need from the hotel. But right now, we ain't got no booths for the restaurant. But I do have a lead. I found a note from Buck's poker buddy, Stu. Seems he's got an ex-fiend working for him. The guy says there's some booths down in Vault 3, but it's hairy in there with them druggies and all. Note says they'll go get him if we clear the place out and get Motor's briefcase. I already sent word to Stu to get ready. You in?
Right, I suppose so. Vault 3 it is. God, what is it with vaults lately? Gonna go to Vault 3 and Vault 22.
Oh, yeah. Stewie sent a little care package he thought might help you. Use them if you see fit. Here, this note will fill you in on more details. Good luck, and I'll see you when you get back.
Furniture hollow tape added. No added. We found the booths, but Sin City armor added. Bad beat added. And 110mm rounds at it. Holy shit. Wow, okay. Alright, some black combat armor, basically. Not bad, not bad. I'll give it a boon. It's pretty good, actually. DT20 plus AP, plus 5 AP, plus 1 luck, plus 10 guns. Not bad. And bad beat is a 10mm submachine gun. I have fond memories of this from Fallout 1 and 2, actually, come to think of it, as well, this particular gun. I've never been that into... Sorry, I didn't mean to wave it in your general direction. I've never been that into,
Have you seen that tower on the strip all lit up? You can see it for miles.
Never been all that into, SMGs in Fallout 3 and New Vegas, but they were awesome in, Fallout 1 and 2. You could get right up in someone's face and unleash a full burst with one of these 10mm SMGs and you just insta-kill them straight off. And it played the most hilarious gory animation for it as well. That's one of the best parts. but anyway. Oh, we gave the Remington its new baptism of fire in there, didn't we? I really do like this shotgun. It's growing on me very, very, very quickly. Hello.
Have you seen that tower on the strip all lit up? You can see it for miles.
Good for you, slightly odd old lady. I'm trying to think which gun I should equip. I like them all. I really do. Although out here, I suppose this would probably be best. Good medium range weapon, although of course this is a good medium range weapon as well, but it's sort of the thing I'm going to immediately reach for as soon as I see a legionary assassination squad or something coming my way, rather than just sort of geckos and other random critters or just the odd bandit. Maybe I do like this though. This is such a nice weapon. It's not a revolver, but at the same time it manages to sort of be... It has that old-fashioned classiness of it that revolvers generally do. You know? I do love the Mausers. I do. They're just such cool-looking guns. It's all shiny as well. It's got gold bits on it. I mean, sort of gold-plated Desert Eagle. I want a gold-plated Mauser. Apparently I can't shoot straight with.
Motherfucker.
Seriously? Wow. Maybe the iron sights are a bit off. Anyway. How much does it have per clip? 10, that's not bad. Alright, I was about to say wait outside, but I guess it doesn't matter. Randall, hello, my dear fellow.
Have you killed Quigley yet?
Yes, I have.
I'll take that finger. Here's your reward. There's plenty of bounties left, so come back when you're ready to put in more work.
Yeah, that wasn't a lot, but he did say it'd get more and more. Anyway.
You ready for the next bounty, kid?
Yes.
Last week, a caravan was waylaid north of town, but it's still a mystery who was behind the attack. One of the guards survived with a leg injury, but by all accounts, he's a drunken ass. His name is Chesty, and he spends his days at the bar in Boulder City. Find this guy and try to figure out what happened. Our client is offering 500 caps for the apprehension or termination of the attacker, provided we get definitive proof. Good luck.
500 caps. Yeah, that's a bit of a step up, I've got to say. Definitely. Go on then. That's sort of a bit more in the region of it actually being worth it. I mean, 125 caps for just yomping all the way up to that end of Vegas to deal with Tom quickly. That was a bit much, really. Russell, are you stuck in... Yeah, you are. Oh, you silly man. There you go. Next time I'll just tell you both the way outside. Hang on a minute.
I'll be right here, Chief.
Did Randall have anything else to say? I kind of felt like...
Hey there. Is the convoy attacker dead?
No.
And quit pussyfoot.
Yeah, alright. Fair enough. Okay. Yeah, I was going to ask him some questions about stuff, but apparently he's got better things to do, and that's fair enough. Though you have to wonder what he does type up on that typewriter all day. California Sunset Drive-In. So. We've got to go to Vault 3, which is down here in the Fiend area. Okay. Maybe we can pick up those heads while we're there. Is that? There is. We're going to go see Cass at the... what's it called? Mojave Outpost. And Chesty in Boulder City. Okay. Oh yeah, and we got to sneak into the Gunrunner's factory and get the manufacturing specifications and convince Henry Jameson to quit his position at the Crimson Caravan Company. Yeah. Oh yeah, and find Keeley in Vault 22. Where's that then? That's all the way up there. Okay. Oh yeah, and speak to the followers of the Apocalypse about that poor idiot at the Khan's camp about joining the followers of the Apocalypse. Okay. Oh yeah, obviously investigate Spears Cavern, but we'll do that later. And yeah, at some point we'll have to go to Cottonwood Cove to go see Caesar at the fort, although it's not even on my radar at the moment, that particular job. Oh.
Just fucked with the wrong ranger.
God damn it! I wanted to shoot him myself. You're no fun, Russell. You're no fun at all. There we go. There's a fire burning up there. Oh, here comes another one. And another one bites the dust. Gosh, yeah, I do love this gun. Anyway. Considering it's not that brilliant, you know, statistically and everything, it's so nice. It's probably going to be one of those ones I keep around just purely out of sentimental value. I mean, Maria is nice, but this is on a whole other level of cool, classy stuff. I don't know where I was going with that sentence in the end, I suppose. I mean, we're kind of going the wrong way here, so hang on. Don't have any new residents down here, do we? Oh, you do. Hello. Kapow. More Viper or Jackal gang members. I forget which. Any more? Or is it just the lookout on the roof? I guess it was just the lookout on the roof. Okay, anyway, we'll stop faffing around. We need to go get back to the truck. And then we're going to drive to the Mojave Outpost. I guess we'll work our way around from there. We'll go to Boulder City after that. No, maybe we'll go to the Gunrunners. I'll see if I can try and sneak in there somehow. Have I got any stealth boys? I do. I've got a pair of stealth boys. I might be able to sneak in. We'll see. I might try and do that. And then we'll go up to Crimson Caravan and we'll talk to this Jameson guy. And yeah, then we'll head to Boulder City and find Chesty, or whatever his name was. The drunk caravan guard. I'm sure that will be a fascinating encounter. Get out of the bunk bed, Bert. Jesus. Died. Ugh. Let me just fold that away and pack this away. We should have done that earlier, really. Yeah. Okay. So, I believe she's in here. Oh, we could play our favourite person in Caravan while we're here. That might not be such a bad idea. She's probably got some more money now. Right. Yes, hello NCR troopers. Cool backpack type jobbies they've got, actually. Messy buggers. Cass, hello. Bloody hell. How you doing?
You come around like a bad habit. What's on your mind?
Crimson Caravan sent me. They want to buy your caravan.
They want to buy Cassidy Caravans? Don't they know it's burned to ash? No. Even times being what they are. Not sure I'm looking to sell. Even for all the whiskey in Reno.
Wait, what happened to your caravan?
Mojave happened. Hit by raiders packing some heavy firepower. Can't believe the Crimson Caravan haven't heard. So if you want to buy all of Cassidy Caravans, you're looking at it. And what I got in my pockets. Still, as little as that is, not looking to sell.
So even if you have nothing, you won't sell?
If someone came up to you and offered you 1,000 caps for your name, would you take it? Actually, you know what? Fuck it. I don't want to hear your answer anyway. Point is, I made the caravan what it is. It's mine.
I have the offer letter here. The terms are pretty fair.
Alice McLafferty, eh? No, I see the zeros, and I know she's good for them. Still, it's not about the money. Dad'd spin like a twister if he ever heard I sold our name for anything.
You sure?
Look, I know you came all this way, and that takes some drive, especially these days. Just doesn't feel right, trading history for a slip of paper.
Well, I can appreciate that, I suppose. If you made the caravan, you're responsible for killing it. Oh, that's a bit mean, isn't it? But I feel like I'm kicking a person where they're down, really, saying that, but No, I'm not gonna say that. That's horrid. Look at it this way. The outpost is the last place you want to be trapped.
That's a good point. It's the caravan clearance that's got me stuck here. I'm sure this bar's getting tired of propping me up. Give me that paper. I'll put my name to it. No sense trying to hold the past between your fingers when it's nothing but dirt. All right. There you go. Caravan's yours. Feel kind of relieved, actually. Guess I didn't realize how much I was carrying around with just the name.
What will you do now, then?
No idea. Maybe head back west? Though the idea of heading back there with my tail between my legs isn't appealing.
You could come with me, I guess. Don't know, really. feel kind of bad, actually. I feel a bit rotten having sort of talked her out of selling a caravan, even though the caravan effectively does not exist. I sort of, it was that line about not trading history for a paycheck that I can really respect. You know what, why didn't, yeah, come with me, and we'll, you know, I'm a bounty hunter, I hunt bounties, you can have a share of the cash, and, you know, maybe you can start up a new caravan or something one day. Seems like a fair deal.
Go with you? And why the hell would I do that?
Well, why not? I could use someone who knows the road. This is true. I could use someone who knows the road, so I suppose I've already got Russell, but still.
So you're looking for someone to help, not just tag along. Huh. Walking the Mojave with you can't be any worse than here, that's for sure. All right. I'm in.
Cass has given you the Whiskey Roseburg. Okay, so we got these three now.
Blazing, as long as we got the ammo and whiskey.
Yeah, guns. That's sort of annoying because we just came from Good Springs, where all my guns are. What have you got on you then?
Let's distribute the weight.
Oh, you seem to have. Yeah, you've got a caravan shotgun, haven't you? That's not brilliant, is it? And I can't really criticize you on the outfit, considering I was running around in a checkered shirt not too long ago shooting fiends. So, one thing I do need to do, though, is... see, it was essential. People have been asking me how you do this. You basically need to click and hold the select button. Normally you just click it once and it brings up that menu. If you click and hold it on their portrait, it brings up this menu. So some people weren't sure how you did that. They thought it was a separate mod or something. No, that's just all you've got to do. I think it's standard procedure at this point to set our companions as essential. I don't like having to reload the game every time they die, which is what I always had to do in bloody Fallout 1 and 2, and it actually drove me completely nuts, it did. I'd have to replay fights sometimes, like 3 or 4 times, just to get through it without my companions dying. So, yeah. It's, right, okay, three of you, really, three of you. God, the thing about Bert is I can't send him to the Lucky 38, I've just remembered. There isn't a dialogue option for it. I can't send him to the Lucky 38, and I don't think I can send Russell to the Lucky 38 either.
What's up? You sure about this?
Yeah, there's no Lucky 38 option, so... yeah. He'd be going back to the 188. You'd be going back to Good Springs, which is actually, oddly enough, a little more convenient than the Lucky 38. I just feel kind of bad sending you off to Good Springs when you could be having fun at the Lucky 38 with the cocktail lounge and all that kind of cool stuff, but... I don't know. I guess I'll just drag the three of you along for now. Why not? We'll follow the usual routine of bringing only one or two of you into a building with me or whatever. Patrolling the Mojave almost. And we'll be fine. We'll be fine. You know. How bad can it be? We had four of them following us around earlier, so... you guys will probably... you guys will manage. I'm probably not giving you enough credit. Besides, you know... talking of Fallout 1 and 2, having about three companions like this in those games was sort of the ideal number, really. So it's weirdly appropriate in that sense, if nothing else. I'm on a bit of a Fallout 2 nostalgia trip at the minute, I have to admit, because for those who don't know, Cass, her father, Cassidy, was one of the NPC companions that could join you on your travels in Fallout 2. So, I've actually been doing a rerun of Fallout 2 in my spare time recently, which is why I'm sort of waxing nostalgic about it quite a bit, because I've actually been playing it again recently for like the first time in years, and I'm absolutely loving it. And I did in fact pick up, what do you call him, Cassidy, with his shotgun recently in my playthrough. But anyway, that's besides the point. That's irrelevant right now. I'm wandering off down here in the wrong direction. My truck is all the way back up there. Yeah, this happens quite a lot, Cass. I'm afraid you'll just have to get used to it.
Grand Monument? Nothing like rusty scrap metal to capture the imagination. A giant iron dick pointed towards the Mojave would be more apt, in my opinion. NCR doesn't shake hands. They fuck you in the ass with a bear cock.
Russell, in future, could you maybe give me some warning before you start rambling on about statues and bear cocks? Because, you know, I need to start recording again in order to be able to catch it, but... Can't you just ignore that thing like everyone else?
No, I can't. It's a giant mockery of the entire Mojave, built to remind us that we need the NCR. Fucking bullshit.
Oh, you're such a cheery fellow, aren't you? Right, truck. This is good. Oh, God. Don't everyone crowd me all at once. Okay. Oh, my. What are you doing, dude? Right, you can all stop being, you know, shadow monsters for a minute. There you go. Okay, next. Gunrunners. You know, in the midst of all that, I forgot to play Caravan. This annoys me. Quite a bit, in fact. Oh well. Can't be helped, I suppose. Well, since we're here, Cass, maybe I should buy you some stuff. If you're gonna roll with us, you need some serious equipment. So yeah, let me think. What could we get you?
Welcome, Sir Orman.
Holy freezy stuttery weights, Batman, that was nuts. There we go. Weapons. Okay, so. Okie dokie, I bought Cass a battle rifle. An M1 Garand. I can attest to it being a rather good rifle, and, well, you know, I wasn't gonna buy one myself because I've got the Lee Enfield, which uses the same ammo, so there you go, you're welcome. You're welcome, and I gave her my shades as well, because I never wear the damn things. And I figured they'd suit her, and it seems like they do, so, anyway, everybody.
Sitting tight.
Fine.
And pretty.
And I will be back once I figure out how I'm gonna get around this. Isaac.
Can I help you?
Any chance I could get a tour of the Gunrunner factory?
None whatsoever. Everything inside the fence is off limits, and the guards have strict orders to shoot to kill. A lot of our high-end weaponry comes from pre-war military schematics. If our competition got a hold of them, it'd be bad for business.
Mm-hmm.
Later.
Okay, right. Looks like I'm gonna have to scout this place out a bit. Let's see. There's the gate over by the entrance there. Bit on the nose, though, don't you know? Wouldn't mind finding a slightly more clandestine entry point, rather than fluffing up my words again as usual. Clandestine is, in fact, what I meant to say the first time around. There's probably not a better way in, is there? Looking at it right now, there just isn't. In fact, part of me feels like it might almost be better wait until nightfall before trying to get in there. God damn it. Alright, well, here goes. Okay. Where's the, okay, it's pointing me in some pretty crazy directions right now, but whatever. Acquire the Gunrunner's secret manufacturing specifications from their factory. Yep. Alright. Now, I do in fact already have the stealthware equipped, so... Please don't spot me, please don't spot me, please don't spot me. Okay. Local map. Need to get through to there. Okay. Very still. Don't you all walk into the... Bastards, right. Oh god. Okay, if I bring this up, I can see the stealth meter thingy for how long this is gonna last for. Gonna run a terminal. Okay, download. No. Persona non grata. One of the Crimson Caravan guards, identified as Robert Wilson, decided it would be funny to take a shot at our Vendortron. He's lucky he didn't get a 308 through his idiot skull. We're currently negotiating with McLafferty for reparations, but in the meantime, we need to update the Vendortron's recognition software to filter out all Crimson Caravan employees. We'll also need to pull some strings over at McCarran and get them temporarily barred from purchasing ammo there as well. I see, so this is why we're... nicking blueprints in the first place. Camp McCarran Order 172. Missile launches 7, missiles 200. We'd like this order expedited if possible. The situation at the dam requires it. Vendortron naming. Seriously, can we stop calling the Vendortron a Vendortron? Let's give the thing a proper name, like Bob. We're not calling it Bob. We'll vote on it at the end of the week. Well, please, please, please come up with something decent. Okay. Download manufacturing specifications. Excellent. Okay, ladies and gents, don't mind me. I'll just be... Oh. I don't suppose there's anything else around here worth pinching, is there? Alright. Can I crouch run with the stealth boy on? Apparently I can. It's a lot more powerful than a stealth boy in Fallout 3. It would seem. Damn it. I feel slightly cheated. Sod it. Off I go. Oh, before this runs out. Some better stuff in the other rooms, but I don't really care at this point. Let's just get out that gate. Oh god. And... Whew! I'm slightly surprised I got away with that in the end.
Let's hit the road.
Indeed. Come on then. Can we drive to the Crimson Caravan? I'd like to think we could. Yes, we can. Excellent. Don't tend to do a lot of stealthy, sneaky stuff in this game, really. come to think of it. Fallout 3 was always the big stealthy one for me. And even then, much less so than, I don't know, Elder Scrolls games, for example.
Hello.
Nice armor. You've discovered my truck. Okay. Okay, everybody just sit tight for now. Okay, so I'm wondering where this Jameson fellow is. Oh, I think he's all the way over in the bloody strip by the looks of things. Sod that then. Hello.
Welcome back.
I have the Gunrunner holotape.
I hear it's business as usual at the Gunrunners, as if nothing unusual happened. Excellent work. We'll be able to use the schematics you acquired to begin manufacturing our own weapons immediately. We'll provide some to you at a discount.
Awesome. Cassidy Caravans has been bought out and is now part of the Crimson Caravan Company.
Very good. On occasion, it's proven to be more profitable in the long run to simply buy out the competition. And this is one of those occasions.
Okay. Reminded about job.
Of course. Which one?
Jameson.
The Jamesons are very wealthy ranchers back in Redding, California, and significant investors in the Crimson Caravan Company. I was pressured into posting young Henry as the manager of the New Vegas branch. As you can see, he wasn't exactly cut out for the job. He was much more interested in gambling and prostitutes, and because of his family, I can't simply fire him. Henry needs to be convinced to quit, one way or another. I won't have a useless employee on the company payroll.
Alright, I was just checking to see if maybe she'd tell me where he was. So, never mind. I was hoping he might be here in the Crimson Caravan compound, but no such luck.
Let's hit the road.
Yeah. So what now? Boulder City, I guess. Onwards to find Chesty or whatever the bloody hell his name was. Is that a grenade launcher? It is, isn't it? Away from the truck, please, gentlemen. None of you are to touch the damned truck. Seriously, quit it. No. Bad NCR heavy trooper, bad. You go sit in the corner. There you go. Right, okay. God, what is it with people just trying to... And what, you two as well over there, I mean... It's like the whole NCR is on drugs or something. Oh god, he's escaped. Let's drive off before he comes back. Let's see, Boulder City. Boulder City, Boulder City, Boulder City. There it is. Any minute now. Okay, right, yes. So, Cass, I believe I've already explained this, but in case it wasn't clear, we are bounty hunters. Oh god, Russell, what are you doing, man? We're bounty hunters. We hunt bounties. That's our chief source of income at the moment. Well, it probably isn't technically, but that's how I see it in my head anyway. And we're here because oh, there you are. We're here because we're tracking down a caravan guard who knows something about a caravan that was attacked. Rather like your caravan, actually, as a matter of fact. And
we've done a good turn for the NCR, and now we'd like to do one for you.
There's an NCR emergency two-way radio. You call, and we'll come running. You're not alone out here. The NCR has your back. Stay safe and good hunting.
Nice hat. Cool, I guess. That was a nice surprise, wasn't it? Anyway, yeah, so we're here tracking down this caravan guard. He's apparently a complete drunkard anyway, and it's sort of weirdly appropriate that we should bring you along, really, because it's sort of to do with caravans and stuff, so your expertise and experience and whatnot may well come in handy. And, you know, we'll give you a cut of the... of all the rewards and things we get from doing this when you with you coming along. I mean, you know, you gotta have the stomach for this kind of work, I suppose. Contact. But what?
Do you like pain?
Russell kind of goes berserk every now and again, by the way. As does Bert. I'm not sure what they're doing exactly. What? Oh, rad scorpions. Okay, rad scorpions just wandered in, apparently. Okay. Guys, please, just... No, stop it.
It's your call.
Motherfuck.
Good.
Now we're talking.
Bet you 50 caps I kill more than
you. Be aggressive, all of you. Actually, you know what? No, sod that. Be, be passive. Don't shoot until shot at. And praise the holy gore bag. Anyway. Oof.
Patrolling the Mojave almost makes you wish for a nuclear winter.
Yep, I'm pretty sure the whole NCR are on drugs. Pretty damn sure at this point. There's really not much doubt. So where's this... There you are. Hello, Chesty.
What? Can you buy me a drink?
Just one drink.
I need information about the caravan attack.
Well, there was a big fucking explosion, and I got covered in Brahmin guts. Mike was shot to shit, but he managed to get one of them. It wasn't raiders like I'm used to. It was a couple of old guys in weird uniforms. It was at this intersection, here. Anyway, there ain't much left there, but you can look. We cleaned up the bodies, but left that old dude to rot.
Okay. Apparently I'm hungry. Gecko steaks? Gecko steaks and overpowered biscuits of doom. Yeah. You guys can, you know, get a drink, I suppose, if you want. I mean... it's not the most amazing place ever, I suppose, but... Just... Yeah. So, yeah. Oh, hello. Am I allowed to shoot that? Probably not. Anyway, yeah. Cass.
Well, now that I'm free of the outpost, was wondering if you'd mind making a detour. I'd like to pay my respects to the end of Cassidy Caravans. Check out the site where they died.
Okay, where was your caravan hit?
Upside of Vegas, hear tell? Trapped at the Mojave outpost. So I wasn't able to run there when I heard. Been weeks since it was hit. So the site's probably a Cazador nest by now.
I think there's anything left?
Only wishful thinking on my part, most likely. At the least, I'd like to pay my respects. I got them into this mess. I owe them that much.
Well, let's go then, I suppose.
Thanks. I appreciate it. Some of the caravan might be ash. But we were expecting raiders and over-inquisitive NCR border guards. There might be something left. If I'm there with you, shouldn't be hard to spot. And I'd prefer to see the bodies with my own eyes.
I had other questions.
Ask them then.
Oh, lots of them, apparently. Can you tell me anything about this platinum chip?
Well, no idea why your friend Mr. House wants it, but I'm guessing it's not for the caps.
You any good in a fight? I'm guessing she probably is. Might as well ask anyway.
I'm fair with chucking dynamite, not bad with a pistol, if I do say so myself. Carry a knife, too, but that's more for practical reasons. Prefer settling things with my fists, though. Made more friends than corpses in bar fights. Plan on keeping it that way. Don't think I'm some kind of Vault City pacifist, though. If things get heated, I'll start shooting. Trust me.
I'm picking up a lot of characters who are into the fisticuffs. This makes me happy. Where'd you learn to shoot?
Short of caps is what taught me mostly. Ammo's expensive, so I learned to make every shot count. And hear tell my dad was a crack shot, so I don't want to dirty the family name. Not out of pride. Respect.
And where did you learn to handle dynamite?
Dynamite's for when you don't have enough bullets, want to clear a pass or scare off geckos from a caravan. Some of Twister's out of the divide can block off a pass in no time, so you learn how to handle powder so you don't get trapped somewhere. Any event, I prefer shooting if it comes down to an argument. Don't worry, I'll carry my weight if a disagreement arises.
Any other weapons?
What, you mean like spears? No, none of that. Mom was a tribal, but she didn't teach me anything like that.
Your mother was a tribal?
You know, like one of the tribes from the east. We got them out west, too. NCR's hardening them up, though, domesticating them. Mom was from east of the Colorado, though. Not sure what tribe. Was before the time Caesar rounded them up, made them legion. She walked a hell of a way until she crossed paths with my dad, and he convinced her to stop walking. And lucky for me, he was a horny old bastard.
One way to put it.
Didn't ask Mom to elaborate. Never heard her complain about his bedroom behavior. Only complain he wasn't around to do it no more.
Tell me about your dad.
Not much to tell. He ended up walking east one day when I was young and never came back. Not a family deserter like some, though. Mom died waiting for him, and she had me to raise. She was sick, but she held off dying until I was old enough to be getting into trouble with the boys. As for Dad, I figure he just got himself lost or dead. Happens. And I'm not all boo-hoo about it, so save your glass for someone who's crying.
Any idea why he went east?
Not a clue. When he left, I was too in my crib to understand why, and around the time Mom passed, I was too into my teens to listen. Got his name, got this pendant, and that's about it.
Pendant.
Gift for my dad, along with my name. Rose of Sharon Cassidy. Mom said he got the name out of some old world book about dirt pilgrims. Name sure sounds sweet, though. Anyway, pendant's a little rose. Originally thought it was one of Mom's tribal necklaces, but no. Came from Dad.
Well, let's move on.
All right, then.
And that is sort of weirdly ironic, because Cassidy, when you walk around with him in Fallout 2, mentions how he got his name out of a comic book. So, yeah. Well, it appears we're going on a bit of a sort of dead and destroyed caravan tour of the Mojave, I guess, because we're going to see yours, Cass, and we're going to go and see the one that was blown to bits. The chest he was supposed to be guarding. What a cheery day this has turned out to be.